How are you all? My name is Harshit Devedi, friends, and I welcome you back to my video. So in this video, friends, I will be discussing two, three things with you. I will be discussing the Motilal Nehru report of 1928 with you, and I will be discussing the Delhi proposals by you, the all party conference that met to discuss these Delhi proposals. All these things I will be discussing with you in this video, friends. So this is presented by me, Harshit Devedi. Friends, if you are not comfortable in English, then you can go and watch the Hindi version of this video that I have already uploaded on my channel. So let's start it without any, you know, waste of time, friends. You know, I have already uploaded a video on Simon Commission, friends. So if till now you have not watched the video of that Simon Commission, please go back and watch this video. So in that, I have told you that Simon Commission came in India in 1928, and it was opposed by almost all the factions of India except one faction of the Muslim League led by Muhammad Shafi and Justice Party of Madras. These were the two factions who were supporting Simon Commission. Rest all were against to it. Okay, because there was no single Indian member in the commission, and there were some more problems also, which I have discussed in that video. Now, the Secretary of State of India, Lord Birkenhead, when he saw that the Indian leaders are not in support of the Simon Commission, he threw an open challenge to the Indian leaders, saying to them that if you have a problem with Simon Commission, then can you draft a constitution for your own? And he was actually trying to implicitly, you know, say to the Indians that you are yourself not capable of drafting a constitution for your self-governance. The political leaders of India accepted this challenge, and they said that yes, we will draft a constitution for ourselves, and for that an all-party conference was called. And that all-party conference, at that conference, you know, one committee was formulated, and this committee was appointed with the task of drafting a constitution. Okay, friends. Now, who this committee consisted of? You know, this committee was headed by Motilal Nehru. Jawaharlal Nehru was the secretary of this committee. Other members of this committee were Ali Imam, Tej Bahadur Sapru, Mangal Singh, M.S. Ane, Subhash Chandra Bose, Shoaib Qureshi, G.R. Pradhan. Okay, and the draft report that this committee gave was known as the Nehru Committee Report or Nehru Report. Okay, friends. Now, this report was submitted at the Lucknow session of the All Party Conference on 28th of August 1928. And this was the first major attempt by the Indians to draft a constitution for their self-rule. Okay, friends. Now, what were the recommendations of the Motilal Nehru Committee? Let's have a look at it, friends. You will see some modern administrative machinery type of thing here. It said the dominion status for India on the lines of Canada, Australia. You know, at that point of time, Canada, Australia were having dominion status for themselves. India said that please give that dominion status to us also within the British Commonwealth, which means that we will be under the overall suzerainty of your only, but we will have some sort of self-rule for us. Now, when this dominion status was demanded, there was a young set of leaders who was pressing for complete independence. Now, leaders like Jawaharlal Nehru, Subhash Chandra Bose were saying that, okay, we should not go for dominion status. We should ask for complete independence. Why dominion status? We will ask for complete independence. But the senior leaders said that complete independence will be a sort of impractical thing here. We should go for dominion status only, and they demanded for dominion status. But actually getting dominion status also became difficult because Britain was no mood to give anything to India. Okay, then the second thing was that 19 fundamental rights were included in this, Motilal Nehru Committee report, which included the right to vote for men and women equally who are above 21 years of age until and unless they are disqualified. Third thing was that equal rights to men and women will be given as citizens. Then there will be no state religion, that is no Hindu or Muslim, it will be a secular, no religion of the state will be there. Also, no separate electorates for any community will be there. Okay, friends. It will provide for the reservation of minority seats. Now, this separate electorate had become a fashion, friends. It started from 1909, Maulid Minto reforms, and Muslims were given separate electorates. And then after, it was increasing. In 1919, it was increased. Simon Commission further increased it. You know, it recommended to increase it. So, this Motilal Nehru Committee report that just abolished this separate electorate, yes, we will give reservation to minority seats. And it provided for the reservation of Muslims at the center and provinces where they were in minority. But they said that not in Bengal and Punjab. No reservation in Bengal and Punjab. Why? Because here the Muslims were in majority. And also said that there will be reservation of non-Muslims in northwestern frontier province because there the non-Muslims were in minority, like the Hindus and Sikhs. So reservation should be given to them. And all the places where Muslims are in minority, they should be given reservation. But there will be no separate electorates. This was be sent by this report. Then it said that a federal form of government will be formed with residual powers with the center. Now, what is a federal form of government? First of all, federal form of government is a government in which the powers of the centers and the provinces are clearly demarcated. That this one is the power of the center and this one of provinces. Okay. And said that residual powers will be center. What are residual powers? Residual powers means that which at the time of drafting are not specifically mentioned in any list, but as we, you know, afterwards we go on doing governance, then some amount of things come in front of us, and then it says that whether it is under the states or in provinces, because you know, disaster management is something which is not in the central list, in provincial list, in concurrent list, so it becomes a residual thing. So it came into it, you know, went with the center also. So that is the thing, friends, that subject which is not mentioned in any list, that comes under the residual thing. So this said that the residual power should belong with the center. Then also this Motilal committee report said that there will be a bicameral legislature at the center, like this Lok Sabha, Raj Sabha type of thing. And the ministry will be responsible to the legislature. Ministry means the executive. Exit means the present council of ministers, something like that. So the present council of ministers is responsible to the legislature. Legislature can anytime pass the no confidence motion and remove the council of ministers. Okay, friends. So this here also Motilal Nehru committee reported whatever the ministry, it will be responsible to the legislature. Moving forward, then it said that Governor General will be the constitutional head of India. Okay, he would be appointed by the British monarch. Then there was a proposal for setting up of a Supreme Court. Also, the provinces would be created on linguistic line. Now, this thing was something contentious, friends, because after independence, it is going to create a lot of problems. So, it said that the provinces will be created along linguistic lines and the language of the country would be Indian. It will be written either in Devanagari script or Telugu, Tamil, Karnal, Bengali, Marathi or Gujarati. English usage was also permitted because it was important, the need of the hour. Now, everything was right, friends. One thing came as a bone of contention, as it was very much obvious to come. It was the communal representation, friends. Communal representation was controversial. In December 1927, many Muslim leaders met Motilal Nehru at Delhi and suggested a few proposals. And initially, those proposals were accepted by the Congress at its Madras session. These were the Delhi proposals. The very first proposal was that 1/3 of the representation will be given to Muslims in the second legislature. Second was representation to Muslims in Punjab and Bengal in proportion to their population. So initially the report said that in Punjab and Bengal, no reservation will be given to the Muslims, but because they are in the majority. But now in Delhi proposals, it was said that yeah, reservation will be given, representation to Muslims in Punjab and Bengal will be given to them according to their population. Also, formation of 3 new provinces would be there. That is Sindh, Balochistan, Northwestern Frontier Province, and fourth, you know, a sort of joint electorate will be formulated in addition to the separate electorate. So these were the 4 Delhi proposals, friend. Now, actually, not everyone was happy with this Delhi proposals, because the Hindu Madhasabha and all other, many other leaders were saying that why you are forming new provinces on the basis of religion? Why communal representation in Bengal and Punjab when they are already in majority there? So these type of things were coming. And these, they were saying that a strict unitary system would be there to, you know, make the country strong. Rather, you are dividing the country in communal lines. They are saying this type of things. Okay. Now, the report said, the Motilal Nehru committee report concessions to the Hindu group and other group who were saying things like this. They said that joint electorates will be there. And in that joint electorates, reservation of seats will be given to Muslims only where they will be a minority. Okay. Now, here some bone of contention was there, friends. You know, initially, they accepted to the Delhi proposal, and afterwards, you know, when the original report came out, they deviated from their promises a bit. Okay. Now, Sindh, they said that will be created into a new province after severing from Bombay only when dominion status granted to India. And yes, the Hindu minority which will be present in that province, it will be given proper weightage. Okay, friends. Now, an all-party conference held in Calcutta in 1928 to discuss the Motilal Nehru report. And 3 amendments was made to the Motilal Nehru committee report in that all-party conference. First was 1/3 representation of Muslims in the central legislature. Obviously, it was initially said. Then reservation to Muslims in Punjab and Bengal in proportion to their population. In the Motilal Nehru committee original report, this thing was not there. Okay. In Delhi proposal, it was a bit there. In the third, residual powers to be vested with the provinces and not center. Now see here, friends, residual powers to be vested in the provinces. The point is, the more independence and strong you are making a province, the more weakening the center would be. That means the more power you will give to a province, the more control that center has on the province will go away. And obviously, secessionist tendencies will come in. So now, The Indian National Congress and other leaders were not in favor of giving especially these two demands, second and third demand. Okay, friends. So obviously, when these two were not clearly granted, Jinnah broke up the negotiations and he said that no negotiation until and unless all these three things are accepted. And obviously, after some time in March 29, he gave his own 14 points. When these three demands were not met, he gave his own 14 points in March 2019-29. And from that time onwards, these 14 demands will be the basis of all negotiations of Muslim League in the time to come. So see, friends. Let us have a look at why, if these things would be done, what should have been done, what should not have been done. See, the third point says that judiciary powers should be vested in provinces. That was not right, friends. Okay, provinces to be made strong, it should be made strong for self-independence, but it should not be made so much strong that Sikhist tendencies should come in. Then reservation of Muslims in Punjab and Bengal in proportion to their population. Here they were already in majority. No, that should be that if there are some provinces in which they are in minority, representation should be given. And if in Punjab or Bengal in northwestern frontier province, if Hindus and Jains and other communities are in minority, then they should be given, you know, reservation there, friends. Okay. So, and 1/3 of representation of Muslims in the central legislature, this was basically adhered to in the starting, but afterwards, you know, a concurrence to this thing also became easy. So, problems arised and obviously Muslim League broke away from the negotiations. Now, what was right at that point of time, what was wrong? We cannot say, friends, this is not a personal opinion because, you know, whatever happened in history, it happened. Communalism is a thing which cannot be pacified, friends, which cannot be, you know, controlled. It is basically an ideology and it has to be pacified. For example, the people of the minority should feel that they are safe with the majority. And until they are not feeling this thing, communalism is bound to rise, which happened in the case of India, which ultimately led to the partition of India. So this was my video about this. You know, friends, Motilal Nehru Committee Report. I hope this was helpful for you. If this was helpful, kindly subscribe to my channel. Give this video a like. And obviously, if you feel this is helpful, kindly, you know, please refer my video to your friends who are preparing for similar kind of examinations. That will be, you know, a bit encouraging for me. So have a good day, friends. Goodbye.